It's the Daily Game, the Pawnee-Barcelona. We are back with part 14 of our GTA Vice City Definitive Edition Platinum playthrough. In our last video, we got some taxi fares done, did the first 9 unique stunt jumps. Well, we got a few more to go. Let's do 9 more. Then we can check out these rampages and get on with the game. So without further ado, we're up here. We got to go down here. Enjoy.
Because after you spend a day working in a steel mill, you want to wear tight leather clothes and play air guitar. That's what we're about. The recent album was a musical trip through hell, and I think it shows.
Oh, yeah, it does.
Let's move it now.
I saw Satan. He didn't like what he saw in me. He saw darkness, but also troubles. Ask man. I can find treasure in the dark. What's the word?
Thing?
Yeah, that's the thing that typifies me as an artist. Heart and soul. Head, trousers, everything. That's what you get at one of my shows. Jez Torrent and Rob Crisp will really show you, you know. We take the soul into darkness. Bring your lighters. You know, I invented that. I've about had it with wankers ripping off my vibe. I wore women's clothing first. Why? Because it tells you about light and darkness. Like the moon. But seriously.
Oh, thanks, Jez. I've always thought your music really lets people see into your soul.
Right, into great big pools of pain like me. Dangerous bastard. Babe, I've had my heart broken and I am still a man. I'm working on a song right now called Fallen Stars on Shattered Dreams in the Rain. It's about being able to communicate through music rather than words. It's set in a wind tunnel. That's why there's a huge snake painted on my jacket. The snake symbolizes kind of a subconscious power force. Because life is pain, babe. And without music, I'd be lost. This new album is our most mature work yet. I am brilliant on it. Because I sing for...
Passionately in non-violent solutions to life's problems. Gangs have to learn to love, to be inclusionary. We'd award badges to good gangs and give bad gangs a silly hat to wear. It would give people something to feel a part of. Kill with kindness, not a garden tool.
Yes, but what about the guy getting beaten up on the street? Or the man having his motorcycle stolen? What about him?
Or her? Some of the best bikers are really women. Anyone can join our group. This is about poor people getting together.
But your father owns half of Florida. How are you part of the working class?
Like I said, possessions are not important at all. I'll pick up a hitchhiker in my convertible any day. The other day, I picked up a young woman and we discussed a non-violent solution to war. We called it peace.
Your father is a great man. He's done more for the arms trade in this state than anyone else, myself included. And you shame him with the socialist jiggery-pokery hootenanny. America needs hope. Not songs that are supposed to send food to the poor. Songs will get you nowhere. This country needs something to aim for, like being rich and laughing at poor people, or being in government and laughing at the electorate.
Now, Mr. Shrub, let's not make this personal. I appreciate your attempt to press the point, but we are here to press the issue. My city is in trouble. And I think we're not really providing any serious solutions. So far, we've got secessionists rearing its ugly head for the first time in a century and a half. We've got ignore it, and we've got give everyone a flower. You're all a little unrealistic, yes?
Come on, Maurice.
Not to say over-opinionated and moronic, Mr. Crayshaw, how do we stop people running amok in the city with machine guns and heavy artillery?
You've got to give a man a chance. Prisons are overflowing with wasted potential. Make the guilty men innocent once more. Free them from themselves.
How? How on earth do you do that?
Well, you could let them off.
Marvelous. Great. That's a sensible plan.
Then they wouldn't be guilty anymore.
We've been doing that for years, you idiot. How do you think we'd keep prison costs down? They ain't by magic or cooking the books. We save that for education. But, as in most things, we in government are saving money so that you don't have to. When we spend less money on services, more goes to administration salaries and expenses, which helps make lives a lot less difficult for everybody. It's about sharing. Sharing your taxes out amongst the select few. That's why I worked so hard at school, so I could reap the rewards now.
I thought you worked hard at school because the other kids laughed at you and called you a square.
That's a damn lie. They called me Wet Fart.
They called me the Bat because my voice didn't break until I was 19.
So, Mr. Shrub, I take it you don't believe in regulation.
I believe in giving people a chance, not tying them down with lots of needless regulations. The fact is, business is run by moral people who won't do anything illegal or try to get rich quickly.
But since you got elected, Vice City has been characterized by a government who cut aid to the poor, offer tax breaks to the rich, and pay people to dump toxic waste near schools.
Yes, we've made a lot of progress.
And up on Capitol Hill, you were instrumental in pushing through a bill allowing the manufacture and sale of giggle cream, a dessert with potential lethal consequences.
Not true. Only 23 people have died, and several of them probably deserved it.
So, with people being set such a bad example by big business, how are they supposed to respect each other, to act safely in society? And how are they policed by a demoralized and underfunded police force?
Well, I'm afraid that's apparently quite a difficult question, but my solution is easy. I'm going to talk for a long time about a subject not in any way related, and pretty soon people will forget all about it. I'll remind people that I have a great haircut, and that under my stewardship, Vice City has had, on average, 15% better weather than before, while crime rates only go up if you don't turn the graph upside down. Turn it upside down, and they have, under me, Alex Shrub. Vote Shrub for president and you'll have a friendly face in the White House. A man you can trust. A local man who likes golf and laughing and photo opportunities at your store or place of business. Just send me a letter. I'll send you an automated photocopied response. We call it democracy, and that's where the money goes.
Just a minute.
Don't interrupt. Let me finish.
But you're not...
This man won't let me speak. You, Shorty, shut up and let me speak. I'm taller than him, ladies and gentlemen, by at least 3 inches, which means I'm a lot more respectable looking. Everyone knows politicians lie and steal and cheat, but at least with me in charge, you know I look good and I have a very supercilious manner. Besides which, I've been abroad and I prefer it here because I'm a man of the people. Vote Shrub. You'll get richer and you won't feel guilty about it.
Enough! We're running out of time, and you completely failed to answer the question.
I'm a professional. That's my job.
And Mr. Hickory, what about you?
All right. These problems are typical of what happens with an open border to the north. The state is filling up with trash. People who can't tell the difference between a swamp and a marsh. Guys who don't know the first thing about the legality of marrying within the family. That's why we need a river. People, I'm telling you, pick up your spades, go into your garden, start digging as deep and as far as you can. Pretty soon, the whole state will be flooded and ruined, and then they'll have to leave.
Whatever.
We must build a moat to the north, or they will come down and ruin this great state.
And, Mr. Hickory, were you born in Florida?
What a stupid question of all the cheek.
Were you?
Of course not. No one's been born in Florida since 1877, but... I've been here for 5 years, which is a very long time.
Yes, it is. A very long time. Almost as long as this show. Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to Pressing Issues with me, Maurice Chavez, presiding over some of the least informed debate on the radio. In this episode...
You may hide and close your door.
to Jonathan and Melissa to talk to you about public radio in your area.
You're listening to VCPR, the radio station for disoriented and unrealistic college professors.
This is K-Chat. Welcome back to the show. I'm Amy Scheckenhausen, and next up, we're going to be interviewing someone with a lot to say for herself. A woman who pretended to be a man and then wrote a book about it. I haven't read it, but I'm going to pretend I did. She's professor of anthrosociology and women's studies at the University of Vice City, and her name is Michaela Krapitas. Krapitas, Michaela, Michaela, hi, welcome to K-Chat.
Hello.
Hi. So, Michaela, you're a teacher.
If you mean professor, yes, I have a doctorate. Teachers are homely women who make minimum wage to keep the teenage boys off the streets during the day. I am very intelligent, and I'd rather talk about that. I'm trying to sell my book.
Okay. Now, it says here you wanted to be a man so much, you dressed up.
Quite frankly, and a disaster for the planet.
That wasn't very sporty of you.
I miss the flight to Narita.
You grew out your body hair and wore boots, for example. You mustn't get sucked into their heteropatriarchy.
But I like dating. Having someone buy you dinner is great.
Well, we'll come back to you and your problems, accepting who you really are. Let's talk about me a bit.
Okay, so tell me about your book. You hate men a lot, and you dressed up like one, and now you've written a book about it, right?
More or less. As I said, I'm very intelligent, so I don't expect you to understand, my dear. Revolted, of course, but fascinated. Now, as an academic, I can get paid to write a book about pretty much anything, as long as I give it a complicated title. Are you with me, gorgeous?
Ooh, I think so.
Good. Then hold my hand. It helps me think.
No!
Okay, sorry. Don't be so weird. God, every...
3 months of their lives. They'll enjoy bingo, complaining, mumbling incoherently, skinny dipping, and organ donation. And once a month, it's our famous Lucky Dip medication switching night. Musty Pines is located at a luxurious location overlooking Vice City's state-of-the-art sanitation facilities. You can still visit your old people, but now you have the comfort of knowing
Watch
you don't
out.
Have to. After they pass on to something better, guaranteed in 3 months or less, you can start enjoying their money. Finally, you can have quality family time again. Musty Pines. Now, you don't have to say goodbye. Drive-through service also available.
This is emotion. Let's keep on with the power. This track will break your heart. It's the power of music. Oh, magnificent. I touch myself.
Motorist,
What about you? Do you like that one? Does it make you tremble and quiver and groan and feel alive? I play the music that makes the people feel touched. Don't go away.
Ever since Linda started working, our kids are home alone.
We tried hiring a nanny, but she wanted health insurance.
Yeah, right. That's when we got the Mestabot. He's great with the kids.
Mrs. Lawrence, Tommy has some skin magazines under the bed.
And he helps us, too.
Would you like your drink version?
He's a great conversation piece at our special parties.
Please put your car keys in the head and the fun will begin.
It's like having a personalized alarm clock.
Says 10 phrases, he's the friend you've always dreamed of. Order Domestabot today.
Hello, I am Fernando Martinez. I think by now you know I am an emotional kind of guy. People stop me in the street and say, Fernando, what the hell is wrong with me? Silk shirt, hairy chest, enough aftershave to drown a household pet, but I still cannot get a woman. I tell them you are an ignorant fool without a symbol of power and fertility around your neck. What kind of woman is going to respect you? That is why I have teamed up with Medallion Man, the shop for medallion needs. Medallion Man caters to all levels of masculinity. For the strong, silent type, a medallion the size of a hubcap will say everything that needs to be said. Even singing medallions for the Casanova, who knows, music is the food of love. Model frames, dollhouses, diapers, whatever your interest, we've got the medallion for you. Don't forget, everyone knows, if you can't support a medallion, you can't support a family.
Say hello to sexual ambiguity. Play. One out, three. Have you ever enjoyed the experience of looking at the world from a glider? It's a profound experience that I have found very interesting. Of course, it's not a cheap pastime, but I think if we have learned anything by now, is that money is a good thing. Only the people without it complain. Anyway, I digress, and as a great man once told me, nobody likes a word.
You know what I mean, man?
Remember to listen all day, like even when you're sleeping. We're going to be giving away the flash.
On Friday nights, I just can't stop eating Rusty Brown's ring donuts.
Oh my god, it's so good.
Sometimes I like to wear women's panties and walk around Fifth Street.
When you go downtown, make sure you enjoy Rusty Brown's ring donuts.